Yeah, I will. Okay, cool. Just making sure. Yeah, that seems like a good idea. But I usually don't fail it. There you go. I just love resetting on ages, having to sit through this long cutscene every single time. So what I'm thinking is, if for whatever reason I fail the power ring manip, I might just do some practice on that and then do some runs tomorrow. Like, that's the one thing that I'm really concerned about, is the power ring and then holding onto the potion for the entire time. Even though you really don't use the power ring that much. I mean, the biggest concern is Dungeon 4. Alright, let's try not to screw this up this time. We'll do three. That way I have to do one more slash. And we'll just do a shovel cancel with it. There we go. All right, let's see if we can do extended. Yeah, that wasn't good. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do for that setup. I know exactly what happened is I moved a little too far to the right before I pushed the block. I might just do a dig when we get to the next screen anyway, and just see. Like, we'll just see if we get one. Probably not. No, of course not. Oh yeah, for this category, you want to move it to the right side, just to be a little bit faster. That was a good heart. I needed that heart. Thank you. Yeah, thanks for the good luck, Kaiser. So I think we're at 17. Yeah, this is a great game. 18. So I need 10 more. Before we do the manip. Which realistically, if we get two cycles of small ghosts, that's six, then we just need four more. Which you can get from the Stalfos on the way to the bracelet. But we'll see how many cycles we get. We only got one that we actually killed. Alright, that was two cycles. That was a really bad fight. No, I'm not playing on emulator, I'm playing on console. Kill both of those, and we're good. At least we should be good. Alright, let's try this out. GameCube. Alright, that should be it. We're good. Alright, so far we're on manip. Two highs, next high, then we're looking for a low. I'm still like trying to remember this manip. This is one of those like really tricky ones. There we go. Cool. And I know that's correct because everything is in the exact position that I need it to be. And then I did my five slashes. So this should be the power ring level 2. And it is. Okay. Now I have to figure out how I'm gonna do this. It should still work. The manip should still be fine because we're doing 7 transitions. We'll just do the 7 transitions and then dig. Put shovel over my ember slot. That way I'll keep the bracelet out. This is a pretty sloppy start, but we'll keep it going. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, cool. Alright, so we're back on track. We got our rupees. We've got our ring. We got our potion. Now it's just a matter of doing these dungeons and stuff. So the biggest concern I have at this point is I have to do D2 skip. I haven't done D2 skip on console in a very long time. I will take those rupees, actually. You know, come to think of it, I don't think I've ever done D2 skip with Maple. I know it extends the amount of slashes you have to do, but I'm not sure by how much. That could be an issue. But it's still the same pattern that we're looking for, so it's not a huge deal. I just have to look for the mid-mid-high. Because I guarantee I'm not going to have Maple here. Because we did the minute for Maple earlier. Because there's no way I hit another 30 enemies at this point. Yeah, and we're pretty much guaranteed to kill, like, 20 enemies in Dungeon 2. I should have done the bomb setup. I will take the hearts because we're packing a potion. So anything I can do right now to just avoid killing unnecessary enemies is going to be good. There's no way around these guys right now.
Thank you.
That case was in the way. There's nothing I can do about it. Alright, here we go. Yes, I have. I haven't run this exact route before, but I have run this game before. Yeah, there's Maple. Okay, there we go. That was quite a few slashes. Like, I knew it was gonna be quite a few slashes, I just didn't realize just how many. See if I can do this. I've been practicing first try. Nope. I didn't even get a chance to try it. Oh, I'm in the cave. Whatever. Oh, nice. So, second try. That was a good one. That was a good D2 skip. I shouldn't have any issues with the bomb jump, but we'll see, I guess. I mean, the bomb jump is, like, kind of free now. But we will see. Alright. Get out of my way, dude. So just in case, I'm doing a safety save. This is a safety save in case I either die and waste my potion, or I die and waste my potion. Because we don't want to waste that potion. Alright, first try. Easy peasy. So now we are back on sequence, after we broke out of the sequence to get those Pegasus seeds by collecting that rope. That rope is the key item that's going to put us back into the sequence that we need to be in. Say goodbye to Moosh. Moosh is no longer with us, unfortunately. I just realized I have not practiced shovel dupes at all. Oh, it should still be fine. I mean, I also have not practiced 7 or 8 at all, either. Alright, gotta get my satchel upgrade. And now it's off to Crescent Island. Got that pirate look. Alright, time for some shovel dupes. We'll see how well this goes. I'm not expecting the best. Considering I haven't practiced, but, you know, it's whatever. It is what it is. First try. First try. Of course I get double first try. Like, all things considered, like, this run is not awful. Like, in terms of, D2 skip, getting power ring manip first try, shovel dupes, like, all that stuff combined has been going pretty decently. It's just, like, the little things are a little off. I screwed up extended manip. Few things have like taken me a little bit, but it's not too bad. Oh, I did not expect him to appear there. I'm gonna take the power ring off just so I can do the kind of manip that I know. Even though I never really get this manip down all the way, we can hopefully take it a little bit. Yeah, no, this isn't the manip. I can tell right now. Thank you. You know, it's fine. We don't need the manip. We're able to do this without manip, okay? That makes me feel a little bit better, getting that heart. Because I was thinking this Armas room might be a little bit of a jerk. With two hearts. Oh, they're being jerks today. Okay. We did it! Gotta be a little careful now, because I only have one heart. I will take that fairy. I will take that fairy. In fact, now that I have the fairy, I meant to do that. You know what? I should probably take off the power ring because I'm not using sword right now. I'll put the power ring back on for the mini boss. Especially since I have to make an equip here anyway. Alright. That got a little sketchy, but we're fine. Oh, come on. Oh, I didn't need that. Wait, I still have the power ring on, don't I? Yeah, I do. I don't need that right now. Managing the power ring is one of the hardest parts about this run. Alright, I'm gonna get some health. Free health. Maybe I'll do this. Oh, nope. Never mind. We should be fine. Whatever. We made it through. That's all that really matters. Made it through the dungeon. That's two essences collected. Here's the reason we needed those rupees to get our flute. Yeah, D2 skip with second try. No, I did not get D3 manip. I didn't even get to the polls' voices. I'm excited to try D2 Text Warp on console. That'll be fun. Yeah, I'm doing Sagan's setup. That thing is so good. Yeah, I'll try Bookless. I've been practicing it. I figured out there's a decently large frame window that you can hit it. So it's not super precise. Yeah, you can also do it a couple frames before that, too, when he's falling back down. Okay, get out of my way. That is not good. I mean, we might be able to get some health back, but it's gonna be rough. Oh, that sucks. Yeah. I feel like I've done that before too, where like I tried to death warp with a potion. I think I did that in a rando once. Alright, we're taking the safe and we're gonna take out the sword. Do I still have the power ring equipped? I think I do. Probably do. No, I don't. You reset so many times without saving. Like, you don't have to do it that fast. You can wait a second before you reset. I don't know, I've always, like, made sure it saved before I reset. Like, that's always how it's been. So that's how my muscle memory is. Yeah, I don't know if it's really worth, because you don't really use it that much, if anything. I don't even think I need that. I'll remember. Alright, I'm saving before I do this. Just in case I screw something up. I think I'm pixel too high. There we go. Alright, cool. I do the further left on the second one. I know what I'm doing. Thank you. Because I know if you just hold up left, you end up in the torch and you get stuck. Is it faster to go up left there? I have no idea. I just follow what Sagas does. Because, like, I've never really messed around with that text warp. I've just seen it done. So that's what he does in his run. So that's what I did. D5. What? It got caught on the corner? So this dungeon has like a couple different ways you can go about doing it. It starts with this setup every time. But then you can do two different paths. And it doesn't make any difference. Because each one ends in a save and quit. But I think this one that I'm doing now is probably the best route. Because you're going to fill up on Ember Seeds after this. Where are you guys? Yeah, once you get into things, like, you could just keep finding other things you want to do. I think 3 should be fine. Yeah, that should be good enough, I think. Like, one of these days I want to do Link's Awakening, Oracles, Minish Cap all together. But I know that's going to take a while. And I have to, like, fully de-rust all the other games. So according to Sagas, this is slightly faster. What was that? I don't even know what I did there. I pulled the pot, but I pushed it. Yeah, because now we can do the warp to go through the portal. And I've already got Cane of Samaria out, so I can just put it on the button. Ah, that was bad. Getting sketchy. You know, it's times like these that I wish I had a boomerang. Yeah, there's no reason to use a power ring in this dungeon at all. And thankfully there are the pots with hearts, so I can just easily get some health back. What did I do there? And even for the boss, you really don't need Power Ring. It only makes him take 2 hits instead of 3. But it makes you take more damage, so it's like not even worth it. The last phase? That's the strat. That's the last phase strat. The thing is so good. That's from like Paladrima days. Like, I think I stole that from Paladrima's run. Thank you. Yeah, it's super consistent too. So it's not awful at all. Went the wrong way. Oh yeah, I'm supposed to put power ring on for this entire dungeon. Yeah, about that. I'll put power ring on later in the dungeon. I'm not gonna do it for this early part. The early part is the hard part. It's not awful, but if you start being bad, then yeah, it's gonna add up really quickly. Yeah, you get the fairy. So, fairy is nice. But there's like not a ton of things that you have to kill. So there's no point in risking yourself this early. Like, at this point, I'll equip it. Cause there's a Stalfos. And then this room. Always get in the way. Yeah, pushing those little blocks is like really awful. Thank you. Oh, that sucks. Yeah, you want to wait for the key. Wait for the key, then jump in the lava. Yeah, if you try and time it a little too perfectly, it's gonna happen. There's no way around it. Like, it'll happen once in a while if you time it a little too perfectly. Yeah, jumping over him makes that part, like, super easy. Come on. This part gets a little sketchy sometimes because of all the keys. I'm actually gonna take the ring off right now because I'm not using it for anything. Oh, what? Three of them right next to the button. Oh yeah, that would have sucked. Because I would have lost my potion. I wouldn't have died, I would have lost the potion. And still losing a potion is awful. Wait, do I still have it equipped? I do. We don't want it equipped right now. We want to keep it off until we get to the boss. This boss actually is not bad with Power Ring. I figured that out in my practice. You just have to kill a couple of the Patra sentries before you start going for it. Like, if you kill a couple of the sentries, you're fine. Because you can one-cycle them. Holy crap. That was rough. Because the worst part about that is you have to reload the room if you fall into the lava there. always take care of him and get your fairy. So here we go. Easy peasy. Yeah, you can. But you're risking a lot more death. You've never seen someone die to him? I died to him in a rando once. What? All right, we're good. What's my aim time? Probably sub, at least sub 245. I feel like I could definitely do better, but I have no idea what my ability gives me with this route, because I haven't done a power ring route before. Mm-hmm. And I don't know exactly how much time this route saves over the other route. Yeah, Power Ring doesn't save much in all essences, or any percent. Because you really don't use it that much. I mean, unless you just go all in and keep the Power Ring equipped the entire time. You still get the minus 50 even if you don't have any points. So you wanna still slash down regardless. No, that's not JP exclusive. That's in every version. No, you don't get negative score. You just get the text. You don't want the text. That's the main thing. I've never really tested it. I just know you just want to slash down because of the text. Thank you. Let's go. All right, dungeon 6. Yo, the off-screen snipe. But I still have to find the other keys. Coming for me. Oh, okay. He didn't want to play today. He's waiting for round two. That's what's happening. He's waiting for round two. Alright, safety strat. Alright, I'll take a look at that later. Thank you. Oh. Oh, I think I have the power ring on, that's why. I probably have the power ring on. Yeah, I do. That's why it was weird. What's going on? There we go. One, 2, 3. Okay. I'll take 3. Yeah, I have no idea how a wire manipulates, like, wire's RNG works. So I just, don't care. Whatever. It is what it is. I need it the other way around. I always, like, want to put stuff on B, and then I realize I need it on A. My thoughts on LADX versus this. I like LADX. It's a very different game. Both, like, in play style and in terms of the speedrun. They're all good in their own rights. And I'm super excited for the Switch version. Like, I don't think the Switch version is gonna have, like, that many interesting glitches and breaks like the originals. But I think it's still gonna be a good run. And, like, a fun, comfy, cozy run. I don't think it's gonna have anything with Link Between Worlds. It's a very, very different engine. Like, this new one reminds me a lot of 3D Dot Game Heroes. At least in terms of, like, aesthetics. And I don't remember if 3D Dot Game Heroes has a lot of glitches or anything. But that's also not a Zelda game either. traditional Zelda. It's a Zelda-like. I'm sure, like, a lot of the things that are Mario enemies are probably gonna have better looking sprites or better looking models. Because, you know, on the Game Boy, there's only so much they can do. The Yoshi doll is definitely there. They've shown that off. They've shown off the trending game. Easy fight. Now this is the part of the route that I didn't practice. So we'll see how this goes. Yeah. Having, like, only the set warp points made it a little bit cumbersome to get around. But it's not too bad once you know what you're doing and where you're going. I still have it equipped. I knew I still had it equipped. I was like, do I still have the power ring equipped? There's no reason for me to equip the power ring for a while. I'll watch it after the run. I don't want to watch during a cutscene. Yeah, the sword upgrade in Link's Awakening is not the greatest, having to get 20 seashells in order to upgrade it. But Piece of Power is, like, super awesome. Yeah, the final boss was a combination of a lot of things. So it was You got to use a lot of different things, a lot of mechanics. Whereas the bosses in this game, like, there's only like three phases, whereas there's like seven phases in Link's Awakening. Yeah, Twin Rova and Ganon can be very difficult depending on which game you're playing on and what items you have. Yeah, definitely easier in season just because having easy access to the level 2 sword as well as having cape. Plus Slingshot shoots seeds a little bit faster than the seed shooter. Yeah, Slingshot is a better attacking item in general. Even without the Hyper Slingshot, it's still the better attacking item. So I always forget when I come this way in vanilla that I have to talk to the fairy first before I can get the item. Or wait, if I'm doing Bookless, I can go straight to the item, right? But I probably want to talk to the fairy first anyway. at least as far as I know, like, you can't pick it up without the book or without talking to the fairy. Or maybe that's just because of Bookless. You skip talking to the fairy? Okay. Alright, let's try this. Nope. There we go. So that's something that I can save a little bit of time on. Because I didn't even realize you can skip talking to the fairy if you do Bookless. Let's go enter Jabu Jabu. Let's see if I remember where the keys are and not other things. Like, I sort of remember the route through here. But at the same time, it's like, maybe not? Also, this is another dungeon where you probably don't need a power ring on too much. Sure, powering would have helped right there, but it's not necessary. Now, don't save and quit here. We gotta go back this way. So I have to go do... Okay, I know what I'm doing. This route is very linear once you know what you're doing, because there's only one thing you can do at a time. How did I not grab that key? So now I need to raise the water level all the way up. And get the two remaining keys. So now we can get this key here, and then we can go get our boss key. We can also just get bodied by everything along the way. I'm not going to use the Saga strat here because that's very risky. And I haven't practiced it, so there's that too. Oh yeah, that's a split. Yeah. I don't know if I need those Gale Seeds, but I'm grabbing them anyway. I know I'm going to be going on a Gale adventure after this. But I think I only need like 4 or 5 more total. Alright, where's the boat? Where you at? Where you at, bro? All the way in the top corner. Oh yeah, I have plenty of Gale Seeds. Hi, Raft. Bye, Raft. Oh yeah, you want to use Gale Seeds here anyway. So, it's probably a good idea that I filled up. I have enough bombs, so I don't need to get a bomb there. Oh, I had the power ring equipped this entire time. Who knew? Internet not working. That's what it looks like. Alright, hopefully internet is back. Ooh. We should be good now. Ooh, I'm gonna need more bombs. Bombs are over here. Yeah, we aren't dropping any frames, so we should be okay. Blue Stolfos. This guy's a mini boss. He can be difficult, but with the power of the ring, we should be okay. Oh, that's not good. Okay. Do I even need... Do I need the power ring for anything at this point? I don't think I do. I mean, there is the one ball and chain soldier that I have to fight, but that's not for a little bit. I usually like to farm up to like 30 for this. That's usually more than enough. I am taking those hearts. No chances. Now I don't even need this anymore. I don't need the power ring until the final boss at this point. Alright, so it's time to go to the boss fight. Alright, easy fight. Alright, let's go! Black Tower time! So many like-likes in the way. Nothing I can really do about that. You want to play? No, he doesn't want to play today. Oh, I missed a split. That was supposed to be when I used the seed to get in here. Assuming I don't die, as I haven't tried powering strats. Cool. And the fear of death. Alright. What phase do we got? Gimme B, gimme B. It's Spider. Alright, cool. There we go. 234.17. Nice. So that's second place. Only behind Sagas. Awful run. It definitely could have been better, though. There's a lot of things that I could have done a little bit better. I could learn the Varin Manip. That would help a little bit. But I don't think I really need to learn it at this point. There's still a lot more things that I can clean up before I have to work on that. But still, second try, D2 skip, that was really nice. Got the power ring manip, first try. I kept my potion all the way through. It was an okay run. And considering I haven't played this category in like a couple months, and this is the first time doing this route, a PB like this is not bad at all. Because this is what, like an 8-minute PB? I like a 2:42, I think. With the other route. So the plan right now is for me to submit to AGDQ any percent, no D2 skip, all essences, and all essences, no D2 skip, as well as I'll probably try and submit a linked category. I might do the old any percent linked with any percent ages and all dungeons, all essences, seasons. Just because I haven't had a chance to do runs of the other linked categories yet, and submissions are ending this weekend, so I don't really have a lot of time to work on all that. And then I think I'm also gonna submit seasons any percent. and then we'll just see what gets in and what doesn't. Hopefully, out of all of that, something gets in. But you never know.